next part is here. So I have removed all the checks from this file, and I have made a check here, and then I'm because I'm going to direct the file flow call, and then I'm going to make a check here flow call. So when I click on the stem button, then this file is directed, and again admit, and bus data value is again will be data of line data, and data from the bus data VAL again will be put into this file, and then there is a calculation for it. Actually this calculation is for the active loss and reactive loss that is caused without DG. So here is the calculation. Because in previous this file we have made a Jacobian matrix, and from Jacobian matrix we can calculate all the things. So flow call is actually specially is for, you can see here flow call, and we have input as NB, that is our IEEE bus system. V is our voltage profile. DEL is actually I have to check about it, what is that. BMV is the grid capacity, and the VEL I think so it's so just a minute, here is the file DEL, and here is the DEL, and again DEL, where is the DEL? So here you can see that where are the values DEL used. DEL is bus D4, so just take that, what's that value. So then when I remove this and click on the continue button, oh unfortunately the program starts. Let me again click on the pause button. Okay, so in the next step it will print the when to next step will be proceed, it will execute the power loss without DG and stability index without DG, and that values are printed here. Here you can see that. Okay, these the above value I print by myself. Don't worry about the above error, that will not occur on your side. So stability index here and the power loss without DG are also here. So our main focus is now I have to switch from the without DG, because without DG we do not have apply any type of optimization, and we have all the done without DG. So simple load flow analysis is done here. So let me open, so in the let me check. So actually our program is move here. Let me again start the program by debugging, and that's very simple. Here let me place the debugger here, and when I click on the run, then debugger is here, all the variables are here. Here you can see number of populations, that this variable that is stored here, and number of population is 100. Okay, so let me click up to this step. So these are the things actually. This is the variable int temp pomp. You can just open it up, and this is a section you can struct. So all the other all the variables that are next to it, point position, point cost, rank, then all the stored here. So what's the difference between this and simple variable is that when I click first section, and when I put here command window, when I click on the here, then all the data here, and then I can access anything from it. So don't worry about that. And here is the repmat int pomp number of populations 100. We are going to what is that? We are going to create all the above variables with the number of populations that is 100 that can be changed. So let me run this step. When you click on the step button, population function data, and here is the. So we have created position 100 positions, 100 cores, 100 ranks, all the variables that we have initialized here. So this is doing just like that. So click here. Click here. Continue, and population function data here. Okay, so here is the random SRC. When I click on the step button, so population. So population function data dot position here. Population function data. So from this line we have created a random src. One of number of digits are 4 here. Minimum value is 1 and maximum value is 14. I mean this first part represent the digi locations that are actually randomized select here, and that is 13, 1, 3, 11. So these are the four numbers that is randomly chosen between 1 to 14, and that represent that will represent the digi location. And next this section is the random section number of digits 4, minimum value is 0 and maximum value is 50. That is actually digi size, and let me check here, that is 35, 39, 25, 21. Okay, so these are variables. In next step we'll put into the feed power. So here is feed power file. Let me open the feed power file. Here is the feed power file, and let me open here. So here is the feed power file, and nbus is 14, and there is this is I mean the above line output is going to put here as input. So feed power, let me click here. So we are going to now going to the feed power. I already explained line 4, 5, that is similar to the without digi case, because we are loading data from the IEEE 14 bus system, line data and load data. And here we have main thing, feed power nbus, and there is datain. So here this file is have first is nbus 14, and the next variable represent 8 values, and we name this file, or this is actually input of feed power. And when this this input will be go into the feed power, then datain and this is the same. So just click a debugger here. When I click on the step button, then let me show the datain. So in previous step which I showed to you, that 1313 that variable is now in this file feed power on the name of datain. So first 4 is represented the locations, and next 4 represent the sizes. So let me start debugger here. So all the above lines. So continue. So node locations, first 4 datain values we represent 1 to 4, and next 5 to 8 values represent the sizes. And here is the digi size means we have to put a certain value at specific bus. I mean, if you want to input a 200 kVA digi, then you have to put at if you select a location 9, then at 9 location you have to put 200. So this algorithm will do that. And the next we have PV types, and this above so now from this step, all the next steps are similar to the without DG load flow, but there is a simple difference, and that difference is what? That is these four lines. These four lines will actually put what they put. They will put value. Let me just click here debugger and click on the continue button, and now I have to PSP QSP. Just I click on the PSP, then here you can see that at 13 1 3 11, remember this location. And when I click here, just a moment, so on number 3 1 13 11 we have positive values, and that is distributed generation is inserted. And when you see datain variable here, that is 35 39 25 and 21, that is the x value here, and that value also stored here. So this is your TG implementation here. That is very simple, and all the other things I already explained to you, no need to worry about that. So here is the what this line, this line actually I have initialized in MATLAB. There is a command by which we can store variables at any moment. So this is the step. Let me click debugger here, remove previous debugger, and when I click on the continue button and